Okay, inshallah ta'ala. Let me read it for you all. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يقول راج رحمة الغفور دوما سليمان هو الجمزور الحمد لله مصليا على محمد وآله ومن تلا وبعد هذا النظم للمريد في النون والتنوين والمدود سميته بتحفة الأطفال عن شيخنا المهي للكمال عن شيخنا المهي ذي الكمال أرجو به أن ينفع الطلاب والأجر والقبول والثواب أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين للنون إن تسكن وللتنوين أربع أحكام فخذ تبييني فالأول الإظهار قبل أحرفي للحق ست رتبت فلتعرفي We'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. That's how much we're going to take from the book. But we first have to finish the what? Huh? Tajweed. It's a poem on Tajweed. It's about the... You know what Tajweed is, right? You were here last week.
Okay.
Okay, let's finish the last five left, and then we'll carry on, inshallah, okay? Okay, today we're going to do... Hey? Today we're going to do the next five, inshallah ta'ala. Okay, what are we going to do? The next five left, inshallah ta'ala. The fifth one is al-wadih. Sorry, the sixth one is what? Al-wadih. Al-wadih means what? Who placed this subject? Who put this subject down? Who was the person who established this subject? Who made this subject? The publishing, the author, the person who started it. So we divide it into two. Are we all together? We divide it into two. In terms of al-amaliyah, practicality, pay attention. And you're not listening, you're not listening. And I'm putting so much energy into this, okay? I want you to all focus, okay? Because at the end, I'm going to ask everyone questions. Huh? Wadih. Ayn, ayn, ayn. This is ayn. Wadih. Al-amaliyah means what? It means practical. Al-amaliyah means what? The person who practically placed it is who? Nabila Muhammad. Took it from who? Allah Azza wa Jalla. Nabila Muhammad took it from who? From Allah Azza wa Jalla. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he practically taught the companions how to read. So practically, who is the person who placed it? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? Lakin, in terms of al-ilmiyah, am al-nadariyan, or let's just say a ta'lifiyyah, from the angle of, in terms of a ta'lifiyyah, who authored it first? Who wrote in it? Who published? The scholars, they have three views of who was the first. There are three views. Who was the first person to write in this science? The first was Abu Ubaid Qasim Ibn Salam. The second is Abu Amr Ad-Duri, and the third one is Ibn Mujahid. Those are the three views. The scholars, they differed. The first one is Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam. Some said he was the first to put it. Talifiyah means in terms of authorship. We know practically ilm al-tajweed, who put it? Nabila Muhammad, he was the one who took his companions and they took it from him. Lakin min al-nahiyyah talifiyah, from the angle of what? Authorship. Or min al-nahiyyah al-nazari. Theoretically, this is known as sakina, this is idgham, this is idhar, this is ikhfa. The scholars, they said, from the earliest people who spoke about this is who? Abu Ubayd Qasim ibn Salam. Some scholars, they said that. Are you with me? Abu Ubayd Al-Qasim ibn Salam. They put Al before his name. Even though this Al is grammatically another discussion, inshallah ta'ala. Like Abu Ubayd Al-Qasim ibn Salam. The second view is Abu Amr Ad-Duri. And the third one is Ibn Mujahid. This is a khilaf amongst the ulama. Who said it first? Are we all together? That's in terms of what? Al-Wadi'. Number seven. Ism. What's this subject called? What is it called? It's called Ilm al-Tajweed, right? What's this subject called? Ilm al-Tajweed. That's what it's called. The scholars, they gave it that name. And we spoke about what that name means. Number eight. Yeah? Who asked the question? Who said something? Did somebody say something? Oh, you can't see the board from this side. Okay. Number eight is istimdad. Istimdad means what? Where is this science rooted from? Where was it taken from? Okay? Again, where did he say it was taken from? No, it's taken from the Prophet. The Prophet gave it to his companions. The companions, they gave it to Tabi'een and Hakada. And the Prophet took it from who? Jibreel took it from who? That's how it has come to us. So the istimdad is what? From Allah Azza wa Jalla to Jibreel. Jibreel to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Messenger gave it to his what? As-Sahaba. And then the Sahaba gave it to the Tabi'een and the Tabi'een and Hakada. And it reached us, right? Sahih? So it's the silsila and the chain. So the istimdad is that it's taken from who? The Quran is taken from who? It's taken from Allah Azza wa Jalla, Jibreel, Nabiullah Muhammad, and then the companions and then the students of the companions. Abu Ubayd, this one, Abu Amr Ad-Duri. Ayn, Mim, Ra, Waw. Number nine, hukmu al-shari'ah. Ha. The pen is not good, huh? The ninth one is hukmu. Hukm al-Shari'ah. Number nine is what? Hukm al-Shari'ah. What does that mean? It means what's the... Do you have to learn Tajweed? Or do you not have to? Again, before we talk about the hukm, we have to mention how many types are the Tajweed. Tajweed is two types. Okay? It's how many types? Are we all together? It's how many types? Amali and Nadari. Sahih. Amali means what? We saw it here. Practically. This one is wajib and it's fardu ayn and everyone has to know this. This is what? Everyone has to know this. It's called what? Individual obligation. Individual. What's that called in Arabic? No, it's called Fardu Ayn. Fardu Ayn means what? Individual? Everybody has to know. I have to know, you have to know. You can't go to Surah Al-Fatiha and say Zalik Al-Kitabu. No, you can't. Surah Al-Baqarah, sorry. Or you can't say Alhamdulillah. You have to read what? You have to read it. So the Amali is what? The practical side is obligatory on everybody. The practical side is obligatory on what? Everybody. Lakin the nazari is what? The Nadari, to know the rulings and study. This is Idgham, this is Idhar, this is Ikhfa, this is what it means. The Mad here is Mad, which is Lazim, this is Mad. This is Nadari, this is the theoretical side. This one is Fardu Kifaya. What is it? It's communal obligation. What is it called? I think that's how you spell it. It's communal obligation, meaning إذا قام به بعض سقط عن الباقين. If a group of people do it, the rest they don't have to do it. Does that make sense? If Firas and his crew are doing it, we don't have to do it. The rest we can sleep, inshallah ta'ala. Does that make sense? So the Nadari side is what? The Nadari side is Fardu Kifaya. Are we all together? The last one. Last one today. Last and what? Last but not least. Where did you learn that from? You said, okay, good. Last but not? Huh? You learned that from where?
Cartoons.
Cartoons. What cartoon do you watch? Okay. Somebody said something. Say that again. SpongeBob. Okay. Wait. Yeah, I know. Seen it. Yeah, I know SpongeBob. Yeah. I mean, I haven't watched it. Just in case you might think I watched it. I didn't watch it. I mean, SpongeBob started recently, right? I was an adult. My times was Tom and Jerry and... Yeah, that's what... Huh? No, I don't know. Scooby-Doo was my times, yeah. Okay, let's come back. Okay? And Dragon Ball Z. Do you know Dragon Ball Z? You know it? Okay. Let's not go into cartoons, okay? Tajweed. Number 10 is Masail. Masail means what? Masail are issues, okay? Masail are issues. Meaning, when you study Tajweed, what are the type of issues that you're going to discuss inside Tajweed? What are we going to discuss in Tajweed? And what are you going to learn? Inshallah ta'ala, I've written here, you're going to learn mainly two things. Mainly, what are you going to learn? Oh, he'll write it later, sorry. You need to write it faster, okay? Okay, everybody pay attention. What are you going to learn? What are the two things? The first one is Makharij al-Huruf. Makharij al-Huruf. What else? I mentioned it last week. Yeah? We're going to do the Makharij. And we're going to do the Sifat. The Sifat are two types, right? Sifat which are lazima and sifat which are araba. And those are going to be discussed inshallah ta'ala in where?
In the next future class,
inshallah ta'ala. Okay, we'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Any questions?
No.
So we said, إِنَّ مَبَادِئَ كُلَّ فَنِّ الْأَشَرَ صح? Any subject that you're studying, you need to know these 10. What do you need to know? If you're studying fiqh, ask these 10 questions. Are you with me? If you're going to study aqidah, ask these. Any subject. You have to have knowledge of these 10 before you go into that subject. Now, do we have a good understanding or a good overview of Tajweed? Yeah? Okay, now I'm going to quickly go over it with you. Pay attention here. Who was the first person to place ilm Tajweed? No, you're wrong. If you say the Prophet, you're wrong, and if you say Abu Ubaid Qasim Salam, you're wrong. Which one is it? You have to break it into two. This it requires tafsil. If somebody says to you, who placed Umm Tajweed first, what do you say? Which nahiya are you talking about? What angle are you talking about? Are you talking about from the angle of amaliya, practicality, and then how that it came from Allah to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the companions, wahalumma jarrah? Are you talking about min nahiyat al-ta'lifiyya, from the angle of authorship? Then the aqwal of the ulama is how many types? Three qawl. You have Abu Ubaid Qasim al-Salam, some said Abu Amr al-Duri, and others said Ibn Mujahid. Sah? Are you with me, brothers? Stop talking. What is the name of this subject? It's called what? Ilmu? Ilmu al-Tajweed. Ilmu al-Tajweed, where does it fall under Ulum al-Quran? Ma yata'allaqu? Ma yata'allaqu bilafdihi. How many types of ma yata'allaqu bilafdihi? How many? What were they? Ilmu al-Tajweed? Ilmu al-Qira'at and ilmu? Ma yata'allaqu bima'na was how many? Two. Ilmu al-Tafsir? And ilmu al-Waqf al-Ibtida. Ma yata'allaqu bishakli was two. What were they? Ilmu rasm al-Mus'haf. Am al-Masahif. And the third one is? Ilmu add al-Ayy. Sahih? So ilmu al-Tajweed, it falls under ma yata'allaqu bilafdihi, and it falls under ulum al-Quran. That's the name. Istimdad, where is it taken from? Where is it rooted from? Where is it taken from? Allah Azza wa Jalla to the Prophet, to hakada. Hukm al-Shari'. What's the ruling? Do you all, is everybody, the taxi driver, the bus driver, the pilot, does everybody have to learn to read? That you're wrong. If you say yes, you're wrong, and if you say no, you're wrong. Why? Because you need to do tafsil. You need to say, which angle are you talking about? Is it amali? Yes, then it's, everybody has to know it. Are you speaking about nadari? Then you say it's a communal obligation. It's fardu? Fardu kifaya. It's fardu ayn, and this is fardu? Kifaya. Tajweed, mainly, what does it talk about? It talks about sifat, and it talks about what? Makharij al-huruf. That's not only what it talks about other things, but mainly these are the two. Any question? Any question? Which one? Nadari. Nadari. Any question? Okay, we'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.